Hey, what's up? I'm Jason Howell, and I'm here with the Google Nexus Q. This is Google's foray into hardware development, very first device that they've developed start to finish. Google bills this as a social media player, and I'm going to show you exactly what that means in a few minutes. Let's first take a look at the specs. It has an OMAP 4460 dual core Cortex A9 CPU inside, very similar to what I have in my Galaxy Nexus, actually. 1 gig of RAM, 16 gigs of internal storage, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, NFC, micro HDMI output, optical audio output, there's banana jack speaker outputs on the back, Ethernet and micro USB ports. It supports Google's Play Store, so that's Play Music, Play Movies, Play TV. It also supports YouTube playback. It's running Android 4.0 Ice Cream Sandwich, and it requires a separate device running Jelly Bean. They say running Gingerbread and Up, but I found that nothing else but Jelly Bean seemed to control the Nexus Q, so that's kind of a bummer from the start. But first, let's take a look at the design. It's an impressive design. It's very heavy at 2 pounds, and that's actually a good thing. If you take a look at the back here, all of the recessed ports, which by the way, may or may not fit the cords that you already have, so keep that in mind. But the recessed ports, if you have a lot of cords coming out of here, you don't want the device to be too light because it might tip it over, and thankfully this kind of weighs it down. Around the edge here, you have 32 RGB LED lights that light up, as you can see, depending on what you're doing, and one RGB LED light on the top. This is how you actually mute. The top half of this dome rotates, and this is how you control volume. It does have a little bit more of a plasticky feel than the bottom, which is definitely more on the metal side, but overall, the aesthetic of the device isn't tampered by that, and it's pretty nice. So first of all, let's dive into setup and configuration, which can be a little tricky depending on how you approach it. Without an interface, it makes things a little tricky as you go along, but here's how easy it should be. I'll go ahead and launch my Nexus Q app on my Galaxy Nexus, hold it up to the Q, there we go, and I felt it go. And now it's asking me, where do I want this device? I'll go ahead and say dining room, sure. So now it's setting up, it's connecting. It makes the initial connection through Bluetooth and NFC, and now it's kind of programming and syncing between the two. And once this is done, it says it's finishing, it'll say, okay, great. You can go ahead and play media. Okay, so now I have it all synced up. First of all, I can go into YouTube, and once it's associated with my account, it will actually pull up my queue, and it will sync it directly over to the screen that you see here. I'll go ahead and load an episode of Tech News Today. And as you can see, it's playing. If I turn this, we start to hear it. So it's syncing. That also includes scrubbing. If I scrub to the middle, it pops right into the middle. It's actually a pretty great way to control YouTube from the comfort of your couch. I actually really enjoyed watching YouTube videos with the Q. You can do other things, of course. You can watch movies through their Play Movies. And with the Nexus 7, which I also have here, we of course got Transformers Dark of the Moon. So I'll go ahead and play that, and you'll see it pop up here. Video quality is pretty good, although I've seen reports of it being hit or miss depending on your connectivity. And there we go, Transformers Dark of the Moon. Again, I could scrub through this from the comfort of my couch and control it that way. Now lastly, let's jump into Play Music. And as you can see, I can go right in here, select a Delta Spirit song, and shortly after, the song is streaming to the Nexus Q. You see the visualization, which you can configure, by the way. Now in a perfect world, the Nexus Q offers a social streaming component where people with multiple devices can connect to it and offer music to the general pool, the overall jukebox playing. My experience with it was extremely iffy. At home, I could get it working most of the time between these two devices. Here at TWiT, I never can, and I think it has something to do with the Wi-Fi that it's using. Even though I have this plugged into Ethernet on the back, it's a Bluetooth issue. Regardless, no matter what, it's been extremely frustrating, and I cannot get it working here at the TWiT Studios. So keep that in mind. It's not as intuitive as they say it should be. Now, one big downside of the Nexus Q is its limited use case. You're paying a premium in this case, $299, to do less than others in the space, like the the Apple TV and Google TV specifically. There's no way to push media from your device directly to the queue, which as you use it a little bit more is something that you automatically think you should be able to do with it. There's no Netflix, no Hulu. Overall, it's just begging for these things, and you kind of wonder why it was left out. We're hoping that maybe it gets added in the future, but at this point in time, it doesn't look very good. On a positive note, during the Google I/O conference, when they announced the Q, they announced that the USB port on the back encourages general hackability. And we're already seeing custom ROMs come out for the Q, as well as things like Xbox Media Center being used as a front end to do all the things that the Nexus Q lacks out of the box. So let's take a look at the pros of this. Its hardware design is very attractive. It's easily hackable, which should encourage some interesting use cases down the line. Content navigation of Google Play and YouTube content can be enjoyable when you get it to work. Now the cons. It's absolutely overpriced compared to similar function devices. It's underutilized with the hardware limited to so few uses. And setup and operation can be confusing due to the lack of interface, if not downright painful. So in the end, it simply does not do enough to justify the cost of $299 in the end. If Google comes around and adds more capability to the Nexus Q, I'd revisit my statement. But at this point, I cannot recommend that you buy the Nexus Q. Check out my reviews on All About Android, twit.tv/AAA. And thank you so much for watching my review of the Google Nexus Q.